Ain't gonna happen, man. I was just thinking, I can remember listening to Ness and Dorma before my matric exams, trying to summon some kind of energy to inspire myself. But there is something truly inspiring about opera, especially when you get to embrace it live. And the Opera Angels, an exciting Cape Town-based duo comprising of pianist and soprano, Dr. Lisa Engelbrecht, and mezzo-soprano, Lindsay Thompson, who are taking audiences by storm with their unique arrangements, covering a broad spectrum from opera, obviously, to musical theatre, folk, and even some contemporary song thrown in the mix. And they join us now to tell us a bit more about their most recent collaboration alongside violinist Mark Klutzer. Mark is the window dressing this morning. Ladies, thank you so much for joining us, Mark. Great to meet you. Guys, first of all, thanks for the early start this morning. Cannot wait to see you perform. And how did this all begin? I understand that on the Cunard's Queen Victoria was the official start to how this duo first formed. But what made you kind of make it official and say, okay, we're going to take this on the road and form an official collaboration?
Well, I think we got back from the Cunard and I thought we've got to keep this going. So I actually made contact with the Mount Nelson. And in fact, their food and beverage manager had actually worked on the Queen Victoria and had quite a history on the Cunard ships. And he was delighted because they just reopened their newly refurbished Lord Nelson restaurant with a beautiful Kauai Grand and a lovely acoustic. And he said, well, let's launch a classical music series. And we've done, what, 3 seasons there, and it's been incredibly popular.
And now we've started branching out as well, going to other places. Mm. We were actually just in Plett for the weekend and had 2 lovely, very full shows there. And yeah, we've got the Pool Cleave obviously coming up, so we're starting the year as we mean to go on, nice and busy.
Was this the goal? Because you've both got obviously quite diverse backgrounds in terms of your training and what you give back to the industry. When you are able to perform in this kind of way and building quite a diverse repertoire, it sounds like you guys really do push the boat out, excuse the pun, in that sense. Was this always the goal to kind of form this kind of performance base, or how does it work in the world of opera?
It's quite interesting because when we were approached to do the Cunard tour, I was initially going to just accompany Lindsay. And then, you know, I've always sung as vocal coach at the opera school at UCT. And I thought, well, I'd love to do a little more performing. So I did a little Skype audition and they said, wonderful, 2 for the price of 1 or 3 for the price of 2. And we started doing our unique sort of harmonic arrangements and it took off from there.
Yeah, and now we just play around. We love all sorts of music, so we just kind of lock ourselves in a practice room and say what works. And luckily, Mark is wonderful and he just gets our style of work and he just says, I can do that. So,
So you do actually have a job to do. You're not just here
as
the bodyguard.
So, I do.
What's it like collaborating in this kind of space where you've got the freedom and the free reign to really have fun with it?
Well, it seems to be something that I'm okay with doing. I'm dropped in the middle of something and then I just swim. So it's easy working with them because they know what they're doing. So it's easier to go along with something when it is already sort of underway. So it's easy for me. They do their thing and then I go, I could fit in here. And then I support in where I can. So that's my role at the moment.
I can see there's a very genuine warmth here between the three of you, and I would imagine chemistry is a vitally important part of this. Yes, the classical training needs to be in place, but you've got to really embrace and enjoy what you do. Does it help when you are shifting gears within the classical frame? Because classical is quite popular at the moment, but there has to be a little bit of spice, and bringing in the contemporary and bringing in the folk and bringing in the other elements, does that make it more enjoyable for you?
Absolutely. I mean, we've got so much repertoire now. We really are sometimes at quite a loss as to what to choose.
Yeah,
and it's lovely. We put together themed programs. You know, Italian, we did Italian and French over the weekend. We include cinema favorites with an operatic twist. And as we say, Mark fits in beautifully.
I'm thinking James Bond, guys. Just go with the James Bond theme. That's the next one. Come on, please do it for me.
We actually talked about that. Okay.
I think you've got that down. Just very quickly, obviously, Paul Claver Wine Estate on Saturday the 15th of February with the Operatic Songbook. What can we expect from that?
So we have some of the classic, iconic opera pieces that I'm sure everyone, it's the ones that when they strike up, you're like, yes, I know that piece. So we're obviously going to explore all of them. We've got a few musical favourites as well. We're going to do a few from West Side Story and such.
Brilliant.
And then again, some of our contemporary kind of arrangements of things. And so a real mix.
And it's just obviously lovely. We've got Makudu, who's a fabulous tenor and very well known in Cape Town and throughout the country. Singing some love duets and things, sort of just post-Valentine's Day. So, things
just
like
keep
all
that warm, fuzzy feeling going for a little bit longer. Absolutely love it. And of course, the best part about this is that we get you to perform today live for us. So thank you so much.
No pressure after
deep
Pavarotti.
Breath. I really look forward to the James Bond theme. I think the tux is waiting. But Opera Angels, thank you so much for joining us this morning. Cannot wait to enjoy a live performance, and it's coming to your lounge a little bit later this morning. So stick around.